Oh, mostly it was Lou Laser. We had the same trainer. Lou was a lovely guy. Nice, and the whole family, all very boxing orientated. And also Lou's brother Mark, he used to play for, he was an excellent footballer. Mark, have you heard of him now?
Heard of him,
yeah. Mark Lazarus, he's an excellent footballer. And they all come to be him and his brothers. And I think Lou had 11 or 12 other brothers and sisters. Very big family, yeah. And also, yeah, Andy Pompey. Lovely man, lovely. When he came to this country, I remember, like, yes, he came to this country about 1951. There's Yolande Pompey, a heavyweight by the name of Ansel Adams, another good heavyweight, and another one by the name of Rowley Blyce, who was a featherweight. They're all excellent fighters. Snow trained them all, and also Albert Finch, the middleweight champion, and so many other fighters whose names sort of escaped me at the moment, yeah. He always had a lot of fighters, Snow. But he was a good trainer, Snow. Good man, yeah.
Well, did he have Finch at the time you were training?
Yeah. In fact, Albert and I went away a few times to Brighton to train when Albert was boxing for the championship, where I had an appalling contest, and so I was training both of us, are you with me? So we went away together there, you know. And we used to stop at a place called, what's it called then? I think it's called the Anchor and Hope. And I remember it was a big pub, nice gym they had, and the governor and missus were very nice, and the food was absolutely excellent, you know. We only had two meals a day. We used to eat a late breakfast about 10, 11 o'clock, and then we'd have sort of dinner about 6 o'clock in the evening, or thereabouts, you know. But there's a park right opposite us where we used to run, and the gymnasium was underneath us, actually. Yeah, good experience, yeah.
That's amazing. Yeah. Did you prefer sort of getting away?
No, strangely enough, I didn't. I liked training at home, because I think subconsciously, when you was away, you knew you was away for a reason. Although you don't train any harder, you're always, you know, you're not at home, you're not doing the things you normally do, you know.
Throws you out of your routine.
Yeah, that's right, the routine, that's right as well, yeah, yeah. And sometimes, you know, with a routine you feel safer subconsciously, don't you, you know, somehow the other decided, yeah.
That's what you're used to.
Yeah, that's right as well, yeah.